Hello students, welcome to class 12 physics class. Today we discuss one more important topic and last topic of this chapter, that is solar cell. Nowadays we use this device solar cell in many ways and in many places. So let's discuss how solar cell works and what is solar cell. So, a solar cell is a PN junction diode. It is also consist with one P-type semiconductor, another one is a N-type semiconductor. That two semiconductor diffuse together and this is form one junction. So, solar cell is a PN junction junction diode which generates electromotive force when solar radiation falls on it. So what happened when the electromotive force is generated? We also discuss details about the electromotive force in chapter current electricity and how, what is electromotive force and how it will be generated and what is its function. All details we discuss in that videos or in that chapter. Electromotive force or EMF, that is a non-electrical force generated inside the battery or the cell, which separate positive charge and negative charge in two sides, and one side they accumulate the all positive charges, another side they will accumulate the all negative charges, and because of that accumulation of charges one electric field is generated positive to negative, and one due to that electric field one force also generated, that is called electrical force. So that non-electrical force due to which that positive and negative charges are accumulated in opposite sides, that is called EMF. So what is the function of EMF? They will because of this EMF or electromotive force, charges are in motion. Okay, and the working principle of the solar cell is little bit similar to the photodiode which we discussed in a last video. But in photodiode, we apply external electric field, that reverse bias. We connect the photodiode in reverse bias condition. That means we apply some external field or external bias. But here we cannot apply any external bias. And the junction area is much larger to enable solar radiation incidence. The area of the solar cell, that area in this figure you see that the area, the thickness, the area of the solar cell will be larger compared to the other diode. This is all about the solar cell, how it is consist and what is the function, working principle of solar cell. Now we discuss how a simple PN junction solar cell looks and how it will work. That means the EMF that generated, how that EMF will be generated. Okay, in this figure you see that the PN junction, one P type and another one is a N type. Two types of semiconductor are there, but you keep it in your mind, one region, that means the N region which is facing towards the sunlight, that region or that semiconductor will make very thin compared to the another one. So here the N region which is facing towards the sunlight, so the N region is made very thin, and the P side, P region will be larger, thicker compared to the N region. Okay, if you compare this with a duster, what we use inside the classroom, in a duster that white portion and the wooden portion over there, so white portion is the inside which is facing towards the sunlight, and the wooden portion, that is, that will be the P side, P region. Okay, so one side is thinner, which side is thinner, you have to keep it in your mind, that that side which is facing towards the sunlight. Okay, and that surface which is facing towards the sunlight, over that semiconductor over that surface, the metallic finger-like metallic electrodes are placed over there. Why? Later we discuss why we place the finger-like electrodes, not the metallic path or metallic plate. Okay, and below the P type or P junction, one back contact, that is also a metal contact, back contact also be there. And when that means the finger, metallic finger like electrodes and the back contact are connected with a wire through some resistance, through some electrical device, we see that that electrical device worked properly. Or if we placed a bulb, then we see that bulb will glow. And how the bulb will glow? That means bulb will glow because of the current, electric current is flows through this diode. That means electric charges are in motion, and we know that when electric charges is in motion, the EMF, when the EMF is produced inside the junction or inside the battery, as per the concept of the current electricity, the charges are in motion, and when they will take a path, that means when we connect with a wire, the metallic finger like structure and the back contact, they will get one path and they will start it flow through that wire. So they will constitute the electric current. Now we discuss how electric current will generate, or how the EMF will generate inside the solar cell. The EMF will generate in three ways. There's a three processes. First one, inside here in this figure, you see that in the depletion region, we know that in the depletion region, whenever the PN junction is formed, depletion region and potential barrier also form. So inside the depletion region, we know that immobile charges are there. These charges cannot move from one side to another side. So near the junction in a P side, negative charges are accumulated. And near the junction and inside, positive charges are accumulated. Clear? Okay. So this N region, which is facing towards the sunlight, it's made very thin, because when the sunlight is incident on that surface, that means the photons with some energy, that is H nu, okay, it is directly heated on the depletion region. That means if that N region is very much thick, then the sunlight with that higher energy of sunlight or the photons cannot incident on the depletion region. Whenever they will reach towards the depletion region, they will lose their energies. That's why we make the N region thin and the P region thick. Okay. So whenever the sunlight falls or incident on the inside or the surface which is facing towards the sunlight, it will, that photons or that incident light directly incident on the depletion region with the energy E equals to H nu. Due to that energy, that immobile charges, this is not the charge carriers, this is the immobile charges. Charge carriers which carry the charges, due to which we get the electric current, that is the different charges and the carrier charges or charge carriers. So this immobile charge electrons, charges get some energy due to that photons or due to that incident light, because they have a high energy, that is H nu. When they will incident over there, over the surface which is facing towards the sunlight, it will directly hit it towards the junction. And due to that in energy, photons energy, this immobile charges will gain some energy. And when this immobile charges gain some energy, that means what happened? The electrons will gain some energy and they will break the covalent bond and move inside the lattice. So whenever the electron break the covalent bond and free from that bond, that means that electrons, now that electrons, we can say that this is a charge carrier or this is a free electron. This is a free electron. And due to that free electron, what happened? One hole also we created over there, because the electron will remove from that place or break the covalent bond and move inside the lattice, not inside the bond. So this will be free electron, and in that place one crisis of free electron is created, that is called hole. Is it clear? Okay. So this generation of electron hole pairs due to light, that is with h nu, is very very greater than Eg. You have to remember this one. The energy of the light which is incident on the depletion region, that energy is larger than the band gap. The band gap, the gap between the conduction band and the valence band. If the energy not greater than that band gap, then we will not get the free electrons or free holes, that charge carriers. Okay, whenever the energy of the photons is greater than the band gap, then only the electrons gain some energy and they will break the covalent bond. So first process is generation of electron hole pairs, not the recombination. Electron hole pair, one electron, if free electrons is created, then one hole also be created. Another free electrons is created, then another hole also be created. So electron hole pairs will created due to that incident light, and the energy of that light is great, very very greater than the energy band gap close to the junction. Okay, second process. So one electron and one hole also be generated. Separation of electrons and holes due to the electric field of the depletion region. When the depletion region will form, one potential barrier also form. That one, it also acts as a self battery. Plus and minus, the n side region plus and the minor p side region will be minus. So one electric field also be there due to that accumulation of that immobile charges, positive to negative inside the depletion region. So when this free electrons and free electron hole pairs are generated, due to that electric field, the negative side will attract the hole positive charge towards it, and the positive of the battery or the positive charge, positive side, will attract the negative charge towards it. So what happened? The hole and the free electron and free holes are charge carriers, which will form due to the generation of due to the incident of light, sunlight. So the electron will attract it towards the inside because the immobile positive charges are there, so that side is positive. So it will go towards the inside, and the hole, free hole charge carriers will go to the P side because that side will be negative. This is a second process. First process, electron hole pairs are generated. Second process, they will separate it due to the electric field of the depletion region. Electrons are swift to the inside, holes are to the P side. Next and last process is collection. So what happened when electrons and holes are swept to the inside and P side? Inside means already there the negative charge carriers are there. P side means positive charge carriers are there. After this separation of electron and holes due to the electric field of the depletion region, the number of free electrons inside the N region will be increases, and the number of holes inside the P region will also be increases. Okay, the electron reaching the N side are collected by the, and this free electron charge carriers in the N region and P region, they will be free charge carriers, but they will not move inside the semiconductor device. They will only inside the N region and P region, because there is a no path. How they will flow? they will already accumulated on in the N-site after the second process, and the holes in the third P-site, number of charge carriers will be increases, but they will remains there. They will not move inside the semiconductor device, not inside the semiconductor. Then if they will not in motion, then how we get the electric charge, electric current? Because of this, we use that finger-like metallic electrodes, and another one is a black back contact, back metallic contact. Because we know that the conductor, the band gap is very less, so they will easily collect the electrons, and the through the conductor, the charge carriers easily move through it. So that inside, on the inside, that means the surface which is facing towards the sunlight, the finger like structure over there, finger like electrodes over there, and below the P site, one metallic back contact are there. So that free electrons are collected by the front contact, that means by the finger like electrode, and the holes in the P site are collected by the metallic back contact. Metallic back contact. Thus, P side becomes positive and N side becomes negative, rise to photovoltage. And now, if we connect one wire with this two metallic surfaces, one with this finger like electrode, another one with this black back contact as shown in this diagram, we see that means these charge carriers are now getting the path to move. So now the electrons and the holes are move inside that path, and if we connect any devices, bulb, fan, anything, and they will work properly, because due to the motion of the charges we get the electric current. Whenever the charges will move or in a motion inside the conductor, they will constitute the electric current. I hope it is clear now how solar cell will work, how EMF will generate due to these three processes. I hope it is clear it now. And now my question is there, or one question also be arise inside in your mind, that is, why we use the finger like structure? Why not a metallic plate? A full cover, if we covered with a full plate, metallic plate over there, in place of this finger like electrodes, if you used one plate, metallic plate, okay, so it will cover the maximum surface area, okay. Whenever the sunlight will incident on the surface, there is a no surface, because this is covered with a metallic plate. Then how the sunlight will incident on the diode or the in region or on the depletion region? If the sunlight is directly not incident on the depletion region, how the charge carriers, that means free electrons or free holes are generated? How the EMF will generate it if the that the surface which is facing towards the sunlight, if it will cover fully with a metallic plate? Okay, that's why we use the finger like structure. The space between the that fingers, between the electrodes, there's a space, there's an area over there through which the light will incident on the depletion region through the end region, because end region is make very thin. So I hope your this question also be clear, why we use the finger like electrode, why not the full plate, full cover plate. Okay, this is the diagram, the P side and N side. After the collected the free electrons and holes, if we connect the P side back contact are there, and N side finger like structure will be there, and the RL is the load resistance. Load resistance means any electrical appliances, any electrical appliances. And due to this, whatever we current we get, that is called photocurrent, because due to the incident of photons on the depletion region, this free electrons and free holes are generated, and that's why, and they will collected by the different region, then the conductor, they will in motion and they will constitute the electric current. That's why this is called photocurrent, and this is its IV characteristics curve. IV, why we say that this is the open circuit voltage and why we say that short circuit current? Let's see this one. Open circuit voltage means the voltage observed at zero current. When zero current, when we get the zero current, when we did not connect the P side and N side with the metallic wire. With a metallic wire, that means it is an open circuit. That means that finger like electrodes, they will collect the electrons inside it, and the back contact of the P side below the P side, that is collected the holes. But if there is a no connection between that two metallic that means electrodes and the back contact, then this is not a closed circuit. We cannot, the electrons and the holes are collected by the different electrodes, but they will not flow. How they will flow? Where they will get the path? So that is called open circuit. And due to that, whatever the voltage, because charge carriers are there, so one voltage also be there. So whatever the voltage we observed at zero current is called open circuit voltage of the solar cell. That's why here we write VOC, open circuit voltage. Short circuit current, the current through the solar cell when voltage across the solar cell is zero. Short circuit current is due to generation and collection of light generated carriers. Thus current through the solar cell, that means you, if this is an open circuit voltage, this is a diagram, P side is metallic contact and N side that finger like electrodes, but there is no connection between them. The solar energy is incident on the depletion layer. So this is called open circuit voltage, and this is a short circuit current when we connect the metallic wire in between these two region, P side and N side. This is called short circuit, sorted over there with a wire to make a path to flow the electrons. This is called short circuit current. When we connect this combination, we get the zero voltage over there, but that zero to that, due to that voltage, we get one current, that is called short circuit current. The electrons will move from N side towards the P side, but we say that the we know that the direction of electric current is opposite to the direction of the electrons. So we can say that the electric current will be generated from the flows through the P side to N side, and due to that, the if we can store the power of this solar energy, and as per our requirement, if we connect in this, in between this path, inside the, in between this metallic wire, the connecting wire, if we connect the bulb, fan, so they will also draw some current and they will also work properly. That's why the IV characteristics curve of PN junction solar diode, that is, will be this one. Open circuit voltage and the short circuit current. Open circuit voltage, we get the zero current, and when we get the short circuit current, when the voltage will be zero. The current to the solar cell when the voltage across the solar cell is zero. That means the first two process, the generation and the collection, the due to this process we get the short circuit current, and the power in the solar cell equal to the product of voltage and current, is equal to the product of voltage and current. Okay, I hope it is clear now, and this is a very short topic of in this chapter, but this is very important topic, the solar cell. I hope it is clear it now, but still if you have any questions, please write in a comment box. I will give the answer over there. Okay, have a nice day, stay safe, stay in your home. Ta-ta.